One of my favorite things introduced in Camtasia Studio version 8.1 is the new stitching functionality. You see, it used to be when you made a cut, Camtasia would remove the unwanted part of your clip and then create two clips with a split in between. Now, by default, those two clips will still come together, but instead of being split, they'll be stitched. The main difference is that split clips are treated as separate pieces of media, while stitched clips are treated as one. So stitched clips can be selected and moved together, while split clips are handled on their own. Since a split makes two separate clips, an animation or visual properties adjustment applied to the first one will not carry over to the next. So for example, if I apply a zooming animation at the end of this clip, it will remain zoomed in only until the clip ends. After the split, the next clip retains its original properties, in this case, a completely different zoom level. On the other hand, since stitched clips are treated as one, changes in properties will now carry over. So if that same animation is added on the left side of this stitch, the clip will remain zoomed in on the other side. In fact, you can even have animations that span stitches, something that's impossible with splits. The bottom line is that stitching makes timeline management easier and is especially great for projects with animations. But let's say you have a stitch somewhere on the timeline that you wish wasn't there. Unstitching is easy. Just right-click on the stitch itself and choose Unstitch from the menu. The stitch is replaced with a split. And if you have two or more clips you'd like to be stitched, you can do that manually. Just select the clips you want stitched together, right-click, and choose Stitch Selected Media. If you notice, the shortcut for this is Ctrl-Alt-I. If you're someone who prefers splits, you also have the option to turn off auto-stitching. Just go to Tools, Options, and then find the Enable Auto-Stitching checkbox. If you uncheck this, all future cuts will produce splits, just like they used to. And stitching will still be possible, you'll just have to do it manually. So you might be wondering what exactly you can stitch together. Well, as long as the clips are from the same source file, the file in the clip bin, you'll be able to stitch them together. And while you can't stitch clips or images from different sources, you can always still group them, which will keep them together on the timeline and in the canvas. That's all for now. Let us know what you thought of this tutorial by clicking the survey link here. Thanks for watching.